call will be recorded and subject to monitoring at any time. To accept this call, press 5. To block this call, you may begin speaking now.
Hello, welcome to Convict Inc. I'm your host, Robert Rosso. It is September the 6th, 2024, and I will be home before you know it. Before I get to the heart of the matter of tonight's audio, I'm going to give a few updates about my situation. I have a civil suit in court that I've talked about at length, and that's moving along. I just got a few orders from the judge today, and I'm dealing with that. Also, what else? Oh, the tort claim. Yeah, that's moving along as well. That all stems out of the same stuff. I've been doing a lot of reading as of late. I just got through reading David Livingston, a biography about him. You know, I've always been really, really interested in Africa, and I think that has a lot to do with being in prison and being around guys that want to be so-called white supremacists, and a lot of African-Americans who we've always been divided by race, and then people always have these conversations about slavery that are just skewed. And I swear I'm going to do some shows about some history on Africa and slavery. And there's a guy on YouTube that goes by MRE that actually knows a lot about this stuff. People falsely call him a white supremacist, but I would actually like to do a show or two with him. You know, I bring this up because Livingston, he was totally against slavery. He was an explorer, one of the greatest African explorers out of Scotland, the guy was just totally against slavery, and there's just accounts of how appalled he was by it. And a lot of people don't know that the slave trade went on way past the Arab countries went on way past after we abolished slavery in this country. Anyway, yeah, I know that was kind of random. Hunter Biden, he pled guilty today, trying to get it his way where he didn't have to admit his guilt, but plead guilty anyway. That's called an Alford plea. They didn't give it to him. If I read that correct, or if I saw the headlines correct, I didn't get to listen to the whole thing. I've been listening to bits and pieces throughout the day about what's going on, but I had a lot of other little bullshit going on today. And there's something I want to really point out. Number one, if anybody believes that Biden is going to leave his son, let him do some time before he leaves, you probably are as ignorant as when everybody tried to tell you that Biden was competent still. And even on that note, every time the guy talks, it is so sad and it's sickening what the media and all his people around him and all the Democrats really tried to do to fool and lie to the American people about his competency and his mental state. It's sad. It's sad watching that guy and the kind of decline that he's in. But there's something that he always points out. The question reporters throw at him is, will you pardon Hunter? There's a difference between pardon and clemency, okay? So there's a little play on words, I believe. So I'm going to predict that Biden will come back and then he'll give him clemency and he'll say, well, I never said nothing about clemency, or better yet, he'll just say nothing at all. But what this does is, and this shows, and by the way, this case with his tax evasion stuff, I think was bullshit. No, he's not a Hunter, wasn't above the law, but it's really a paper case. I'm not really sure if it wasn't for all the laptop stuff that he's totally guilty of, if this wouldn't have all came out. I'm not sure. But I really don't care about this as far as how I feel about whether Hunter should have been found guilty of this. The whole laptop stuff, yeah, he did it. Yeah, they've done a lot of behind-the-back deals with China and the Biden crime family and all that stuff. Most politicians do. Look at Nancy Pelosi. Look at how rich she got from insider trading. But it's not really considered insider trading. 60 Minutes did a piece about that some years ago, about how they named Pelosi, how they really do insider trading, but they don't call it insider trading and they get away with it. But again, I'm talking about random shit. The United States federal sentencing guidelines were designed for cases exactly like Hunter's. And this is what I mean. the whole guideline things was about truth in sentencing and was about having just and fair sentences. That way somebody, for example, a poor African-American from Oakland, what I say Oakland probably because Chameleon Harris always talks about Oakland, a poor African-American from Oakland would have the same type of sentence as some rich white person and the Hamptons, okay, or Hunter Biden. So their sentences wouldn't be totally disproportionate. That's really the best way to put it. But what our president right now is getting ready to do is make a mockery of that. He was one of these architects. He was behind this really tough, get tough on crime push that involved the sentencing guidelines, that involved the abolishing of the parole system in the feds. And he is going to turn around, slap everybody in the face, and he's going to give his son, he's going to commute a sentence or give him clemency. And honestly, it's his son. I have no problem with that. And I know that might sound a little contradictory, but it's the truth. I hope he gives him I wish he would give him clemency and a freaking pardon. I really do. So if you guys don't know the difference, a pardon makes his entire criminal record go away.
This call is from a federal prison.
By the way, let's say Hunter gets 12 months on his first case, and let's say he gets 24 months on his second case. Who knows what he's really going to get? I don't even know if it'll make it to sentencing before he gets commuted or they postpone it, whatever. But those sentences would run consecutive. They could not be run together because they're in two different jurisdictions, just so you know. But they can postpone it. Everybody's just waiting for the election and then whatever will happen. If Chameleon wins, then she can do it, no problem. And would probably pardon him as well to get that off his record. And I think it'd be a boss move if Trump went in. I think that would be just awesome if Trump was able to. But they're not going to let that happen. The Biden family would fear that Trump would do something like grant Hunter clemency and give him a pardon. They would fear that Trump would do something like that. I think Trump actually would. I think people are going to be surprised if Trump wins. He's not really going to go after, like, well, Joe's not going to make it around much longer after everything. I really don't believe so. He's not got long. He's in such a fast mental decline. It's nuts. What else? Wanted to weigh in on the Hunter stuff. Can't think of any of the, another school shooter, another little weird white kid, played too many video games, it looks like. Their parents were kind of notified. The FBI questioned them, didn't have enough evidence. I don't know what to say. This is about society. This is societal breakdown. Too many video games. I'm not blaming video games, by the way. I'm just saying, they sit around on dumb video games and kill shit all day long. I mean, I don't know. Maybe it is, but I think it's more of just the whole societal breakdown. Parents not being involved. By the way, I saw that. What is it? Is it the CDC? No, who was it? Was it the CDC? Said that the number one stressor right now is being a parent. That's like bad for your health now. So they're advocating, don't be a parent because it's too bad for your health. Yeah, just nuts, man. Just nuts. And I'm going back out there soon. Oh, gotta say this. I in the past have commented that when I got out, I had some anxiety attacks. There were different times out in public, Dollar General, Walmart, one of the phone companies, T-Mobile, I had panic attacks. Well, I was in commissary the other day and kind of had one. First time I can remember in prison. But I do realize now that I try to avoid the chow hall because of so many people. That's been happening for the whole time I was in prison, those 20-something years. And I just noticed it. Anyway, probably won't hear from me for a couple of days. I'm low on 4 minutes. Take care. That's it. Bye-bye.